Hello, High Levelers, Ray O'Daniel here. In this video, we're going to do something a little bit crazy and exciting. We're actually going to dive into some of the custom workflow actions that Highlevel has included here over the last few months. Specifically, we're going to be talking about the Slack channel integration with regards to workflows. Before we get started, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button. I always appreciate your support. So thanks so much, and let's hop into it. Okay, so Slack is a well-known team collaboration tool that's already existed out there, and most people have chosen to integrate this into their communication. And one thing that really makes Slack popular is just it's the ease of integration between different people, how easy it is to communicate, how easy it is to connect people with different email addresses. They don't all have to be with the same email or domain. You can quickly and easily add users to your Slack channel, and then you can simply communicate with them directly through messaging, or you can actually communicate through them through Slack channels. These channels can be private or they can be public. So there's a lot of configuration there, and we're not going to make this video specifically about Slack, how to use Slack. That's really another video you can take a look at. What I want to show you here is the integration that Highlevel has included regarding Slack. How inside of a workflow now, you can actually send and communicate directly with people within the Slack channel. Now, in the past, this integration has been possible. Now, it has been possible, and it still is possible, if you want to go ahead and utilize the email integration function within Slack. So right now, if you're familiar with Slack, you realize that every channel that you have inside of Slack, you can make it email enabled. You just simply go to the properties. Again, we're not going to do it here in this video, but you would just simply create a channel, go to the properties, and select create an email address for this particular channel. And you can actually have an email address that you can utilize inside of Highlevel. You can just simply send an email to that particular Slack email channel, and then the email would then turn into a message that would integrate into that particular Slack network. So you could do that in the past, and that's a lot of people that I know that have integrated Slack into GoHighlevel. That's what they've done. Now, Highlevel has just made it so much easier to communicate with people. See, when you're only doing an email, one of the bad problems is you can really only send information to either like public or private channels within your Slack. But you couldn't communicate with people directly. You couldn't send a message directly to a user, things like that. So that's one of the integrations that Highlevel has integrated with their new premium workflow adding components. So let's just take a quick look. Right now we're inside of a demo account, and I'm just going to pop this up and just say create new workflow. I'm just going to create it from scratch. Now I'm not going to worry about the trigger here. Right now we can manually trigger this. So, I mean, the trigger really depends upon whatever you want to have happen. What I'm more interested in is the action. So we're going to click on this, and over here, we're going to see that there's several custom actions. Notice that this little icon right here means that it's a premium action. Premium actions mean that you're going to pay Highlevel for each usage of this premium action. Just to keep in mind that all of these ones in the gold here with the crown next to it are paid premium action. So we notice that there is a Slack integration here. Now, one of the things that we have to do before we can utilize this is we have to actually integrate Slack into our GoHighlevel sub-account. So right now, I'm going to, let's just say I'll put Slack in here. You could do it from here. Let's just do it from here. Notice that this Slack is not connected here. So we're going to go ahead and just click connect. And then what that's going to do is that's going to take us over into our settings. I really want to kind of show you this. We're actually, I'll go back here. You go to settings, and then you come down to integrations. And then from your integrations, you notice you now have a Slack integration here. So you can either connect or you can manage your integrations right here. So I'm going to click connect. Now, before we do this, it is going to be vital. Highlevel doesn't know that your Slack connection exists. So if you're going to have Slack integration, probably it's going to be a good idea to integrate Slack, the desktop application, on your workspace or on your computer, and actually be logged in to that particular account inside of Slack. That way it sort of knows there's already a connection, and then would utilize that connection when it tries to connect up to your Slack channel. So I'm actually logged in. I'm just going to show you this right here is For the purposes of this demonstration, I've created a new workspace. And again, with Slack, workspace is the highest level. Then you can have channels of communication and so forth underneath it. So right now, I've just created one called Ray O'Daniel Go High Level Community or something like that. So that's what I've created. And I've created a Go High Level Dash Community. If we can blow this up a little bit here, I guess maybe not. But right now we have a Go High Level Dash Community channel in here that I want to potentially play with a little bit. So this right here is just sort of a playground. And if you wanted to, you could create a new workspace, play with it, play with the integrations, make sure it all works right before you actually go live. So right now that's what I've done. I've already got this created and we're going to connect to this workspace and then ultimately this channel. And notice that I'm already set up as a user because I'm the administrator. So right now we're going to go ahead and click on connect. Notice that it says this app is not approved by Slack. Now notice up in here in the corner, I'm going to see if I can blow this up a bit so we can see this. Right now, sorry about that. So right now, this is just the one workspace that I've got set up and access to. So we have Ray O'Daniel dash Go High Level. This is the temp sort of playground workspace that I created. If you didn't want to do this, you want to create another one, you could do that directly from here. I'm just going to connect to this one right here just for the purposes of this demonstration. Now, right here, we're going to also need to allow to get lead connector, which is the integration with High Level, access to Slack to be able to do this. So we're going to click on this and just simply click on the allow button. That's going to make the connection, integrate High Level. Great, successfully integrated this with your Slack, perfect. Now that that's integrated, that you saw that only took a few seconds to get that done. Now what we're gonna do is pop back over here to the automations. We're gonna come back down and looks like, there we go, just this new workflow, I guess, is what was, I'll just give it a name here. We'll just call it Slack WF workflow. Save it, and we're going to go premium action. We're going to add Slack. Now, notice that we've got this. We can start selecting accounts. Now, this is very easy to get set up here. It's almost self-intuitive. I feel kind of crazy even making a video to help show you how to do this, because I'm sure you could probably figure it out on your own. But right now, some people just are visual learners, so having a video to show them how to walk through this is beneficial. So let's go ahead and do this. Notice that we have one workspace set up here. Now, the event. The event, if we take a look at this, is going to be send, let me see if I can blow this up, send direct message to a user. That's great. Remember, that was one function that was not available in the previous setup. We're only allowed to email people directly inside of Slack before, so this is a nice new feature to add to this. Send direct message to user, send private channel message, public channel message. So any particular channel that you've got or any user, you can do any one of these. So we're going to just select public channel because I don't really have any private channels on this one. And I'm going to go down here. Notice that there are three: general, go high level, and random. Now I'm going to stop here real quick and I'm going to come back over to here. Notice over here, sorry, for some reason I'm not allowed to zoom in on Slack here. But notice under the channels, we have general, we have go high level community, and then we have random. So it read all of the channels that we have and now making those available. So right now I'm going to choose just the Go High Level community. So just a message real quick here. Hi, this is Ray. I'm just testing this feature. So let's kind of step back and take a quick look. Inside of the workflow, whenever the trigger happens, we're going to create an action that in turn is going to connect to Slack. It's going to go to this workflow, this workspace. Then it's going to go to a public channel. Then it's going to go to this particular channel. And then it's going to write this message in it. So we're going to go ahead and do this. We're going to publish it. We're going to click save. Now, whenever we do this, again, we don't have a workflow trigger. I'm going to manually trigger this to see this and just see how this works. So in order to manually trigger something, you have to come in here and I'm just going to use my name here. I'm going to say add workflow. Okay. I'm going to choose the workflow Slack. So this is a manual way that you could trigger a workflow if you don't have a trigger. And I'm just going to do add it once and I'm just going to type in demo for the action here. add campaign to workflow. So again, this particular workflow doesn't really matter who the user is. It's just going to go execute it. And then from there, we can come back and take a look. We see workflow is up. If we take a look at enrollment history, we notice that Ray O'Daniel on this particular day and time sent a notification to Slack. Now, if we come back here and do this, and notice that in this how the Go High Level, if you can, I wish you could see this better, but this Go High Level community is now highlighted. It's sort of in bold. Typically in Slack, if you've ever used Slack, you've realized that anything that's bolded and highlighted like that has new messages in it that need to be read. It's sort of a way of giving you attention to say, hey, I've got something in here to pay attention to. So once in here, notice that you can just say Lead Connector. This is the Lead Connector app. And you see, hi, this is Ray. I'm just here testing this feature. Perfect. So the workflow executed, sent a message directly into the Slack channel, and everything is good. Now, you could use this in a variety of different ways. So let's just say that you have a Salesforce team and you want to have a sales calendar. And let's just say on the sales calendar, when somebody books an appointment and somebody confirms an appointment, you know, you may want to go and you might have a VA or something or part of your sales team channel in here that says, hey, new lead. So you might simply just drop a message inside of the workflow, and the message, let me go back here. So in this one right here, instead of this, you might simply say, hey, new appointment created for user. And then, simply click on here and add the user's name. So just simply like a little message that you drop into the channel to let people know, hey, we got a new appointment. When somebody confirms a booking appointment. So it could be something as silly as that, but the sky's the limit. You know, whatever you want to create in your own workflows is going to be completely doable inside of here. So this is how nice it is to simply let your team know, pass along information, stuff like that to your Slack channel, because keep in mind the people in your Slack channel may not know, okay? They may not know or even have access into your Highlevel account. Keep that in mind. I don't know if you're like this, but your agency, you could be using other contractors that are tied into your Slack channel that do things for you. For instance, your setter, they may not even have access to your Highlevel. You know, you might send them a Slack notification directly to them saying, hey, new user, appointment created. Here's the contact name. Here's the appointment date and time and stuff like that. And that may be that. So it could be something as simple as that. It's how you're using this particular Slack channel. So again, there's just so many different possibilities. It really depends upon your business process, and how you use Slack is the way to do this. So it's very easy to sit back and get it configured. I'm gonna reconfigure this one real quick. Instead of doing a public channel, I'm gonna send it directly to a user. Here it says assign user, custom email, internal user, or Slack user. Right now, we're going to be choosing Slack user because that's the people that we want to connect to. And on the Slack user, now what we're just going to do is going to read all of the user accounts. Notice lead connector is one because we had to connect that account into Slack. Me, this is my account, and then Slack bot. If you ever know, Slack bot is just, you know, default account that's created here. So I'm going to choose myself, and then I'm going to sit back and I'll leave the same message. And I'm just going to click save action. So save and publish. Now, instead of sending a message to a public channel, it's going to send a user a direct message for this. And again, this could be very useful depending upon your sales process as well. So I'm going to hop back over here and go back into the contacts. Select myself again. We're going to kick off another workflow. Choose the same one here. Still going to use demo. So here we're going to sit back and execute it. Now, if we could come over here and take a look, notice if it might just take just a minute here, but if we sit back and we look at this, let's see if we make sure that this thing executed. So if we do Slack workflow. Here's a great point here. And I feel kind of silly. I feel like a rookie here. Why is it that this thing did not execute twice for me? That's a setting inside of the workflow. This is a new workflow, and I feel kind of silly. If you come in here to settings, You have to come in here and actually, for the builder, and add multiple. So allow re-entry. So right now, you need to go ahead and make sure that you add that and say publish, because basically the workflows, once they're set up, they only allow the user to execute the workflow once. You have to go back in here and allow the person to redo the workflow over and over again. So if you do use workflows, you need to make sure that you come in here to the builder and do that. That's why it didn't execute. If we take a look at the execution log for this, it only executed once, which is the one that we sent. It did not execute again. So right now, that's a silly catch, and that's also just good troubleshooting. If you're doing this, to make sure that it works. So we're going to go through and execute the workflow again. Now that we're allowed to do re-entry. So whenever we do this, let's just make sure if we come back in this Slack workflow, enrollment. So now notice we have a second one that we didn't before. So this one right here. And if we come back and take a look for direct messages. There we go. Lead connector. Hi. Again, when you look at this, all the messages coming from Highlevel are going to be coming from the lead connector app over here. So it just says, hi, this is Ray. I'm just testing this feature. So you see, the message came through, and now you can simply respond and do whatever you want. Now, if you're going to be directly communicating with between users, that may be a business process. I really don't see probably a whole big way of using this feature, connecting directly to users. Most people are going to be connecting to Slack channels, and Slack channels in turn are going to communicate with multiple people that are all involved with that particular channel. So if you take a look at this, you see it's very easy to get set up here on the automations. Just the simplicity and ease of this configuration makes it very easy to sit back and choose. You can do it within minutes. You still have access to all of the content over here in the bottom, to all of the same menus, the account, the message, contacts. So you can send high-level information into the Slack channel for whatever you're looking for. So this right here is, again, something I just wanted to sit back and show you that is now a premium feature. It's very easy to get integrated into Slack, very easy to set up communications between your channels or your users. And that's all that we're looking to kind of get done in this particular video. I hope you found it useful of just how to begin utilizing these new premium workflow features. So if you found this useful, click on the like button below. Maybe leave me a comment. I appreciate it. Also, if you have not subscribed, again, click the subscribe button before you go. I always appreciate it. And as a Highlevel affiliate, if you are looking to sign up for Highlevel, please use my affiliate link below. I do get credit for it, and I want to say thank you so much for your support in advance, and have a great day. Hey, if you're interested in learning more about Highlevel, click on the link below regarding my free Highlevel course. It goes over everything that you need to do to get your account created, get it set up, and get it going in about 2 days. I also, if you sign up with Highlevel with me, I do offer a snapshot as well as a client onboarding course that can be used by your client or even used to train your own team to do client onboarding. I want to thank you so much again and have a great day.